Hi guys, my name's Marty, and in this video I'm going to show you how to add Google Analytics to WordPress. So, how to connect Google Analytics to your WordPress website or blog. And this way we'll be able to track our site's visitors and see how much traffic we're getting to our different pages and posts. It's super easy to do, 100% free, and it only takes a few minutes to set up. So, to get started, we just need to open up our internet browser and go to google.com/analytics. Then from here, we're going to click Get Started in the top right. And at this point, it's going to ask us to log into Google if we haven't already. And then we can click Start Measuring in the middle. Then here, we need to give our account a name. And I'm going to call mine Marty's Account. Then under this, we have some data sharing options, but these aren't necessary, so I'm just going to uncheck these boxes on the left. And then we can click Next underneath. Now we're going to enter a property name, and this is what we're going to call our website on Google Analytics. So I'm going to call mine Marty's Website. Then here we can change the time zone and the currency, but I'm just going to leave these as they are. And as we can see, it says here, you can edit these property details later in admin. Then we're going to click Next. Choose our industry category from this list. Select our business size and click Next. Then here, we're going to choose our business objectives and I'm going to choose this one, Understand Web and or App Traffic. Then under this, we can click Create, Agree to the cookies, Accept the terms, and then click I accept. Then here, as we're tracking a WordPress website, we're going to choose Web. Now we're going to type our domain name in here, and this is the website that we're wanting to track. Then on the right, we can enter our stream name, and I'm just going to put Marty's Website. Then under this, we're going to leave Enhanced Measurement turned on. And this means it's going to track page views, scrolls, outbound clicks, and more. And if we click here, we can see these are site search, video engagement, file downloads, and form interactions. And we want to leave all of these turned on. Then once we're done here, we're going to click Create and Continue in the top right. And we can see our website now appears here. And once we've added our website to our analytics account, we need to link it to our WordPress website. To do this, we're just going to click on our website here, and then click View Tag Instructions in the top right. Then here at the top, we can see it says Install with a Website Builder or CMS, and it's automatically detected that my website's using WordPress. But at this point, it might ask you to select what type of website you have, and you'll just want to choose WordPress. Then here we can see they suggest using the SiteKit plugin, but this plugin has been known to make our website run a little slow, so instead we're going to click Install Manually in the top right. And this will give us the code we need to add to our website. Normally this would involve editing the theme code, but this can be a little tricky, so instead we are going to use a plugin for this, but this plugin won't slow our site down in the same way as SiteKit. So at this point, we're going to open up our website in a new tab and visit the dashboard. Then we're going to hover over Plugins on the left and click Add Plugin. Now in the search bar in the top right, we're going to type Insert Headers. Then when it shows up, this is the one we're looking for here, Insert Headers and Footers. And we just need to click Install Now, give it a few seconds to install, and then click Activate. Then once the plugin is active on our site, we need to hover over Settings on the left and click into WP Headers and Footers. And here we can see we have three new boxes. We have Scripts in Header, Scripts in Body, and Scripts in Footer. And we need this one at the top for Google Analytics. And we can see it says at the bottom, these scripts will be printed in the head section. which means they'll be added to the header section of our theme's code. Then, once we have this page open, we're going to go back to Google Analytics and click this icon in the top right to copy the code. Then, once we have this copied, we're going to go back to WordPress, then right-click and paste the code in here. Then we're going to scroll down to the bottom and click Save Changes. Then once it's saved, we're going to go back to Google Analytics. And then here, under the code, we'll see it says Test Your Website. And we're going to click Test on the right. And as long as it shows this green tick, it means Google Analytics has now been connected to our website. So we can close out of this and this. And now if we open up a new tab and go to google.com/analytics and click where it says Sign in to Analytics on the right, this will bring us to the analytics dashboard for our website. And we can see here it says your data collection is active. It may take up to 24 hours to appear in your analytics account. And over on the left, if we click into Reports, this is where we can find a lot more of the analytics reports. So that's us now at the end, and that was how to connect WordPress to Google Analytics. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like here on YouTube to show your support, and consider subscribing to the channel for more WordPress tutorials like this. Once again, my name's Marty from letsbuildwp.com, and thank you for watching.